Chapter 13. Jehoahaz, son of Jehu, began to rule over Israel in the 23rd year of King Joash's reign in Judah. He reigned in Samaria 17 years, but he did what was evil in the Lord's sight. He followed the example of Jeroboam, son of Nebat, continuing the sins of idolatry that Jeroboam, son of Nebat, had led Israel to commit. So the Lord was very angry with Israel, and he allowed King Hazael of Aram and his son Ben-Hadad to defeat them time after time. Then Jehoahaz prayed for the Lord's help, and the Lord heard his prayer. The Lord could see how terribly the king of Aram was oppressing Israel, so the Lord raised up a deliverer to rescue the Israelites from the tyranny of the Arameans. Then Israel lived in safety again, as they had in former days. But they continued to sin, following the evil example of Jeroboam. They even set up an Asherah pole in Samaria. Finally, Jehoahaz's army was reduced to 50 mounted troops, 10 chariots, and 10,000 foot soldiers. The king of Aram had killed the others like they were dust under his feet. The rest of the events in Jehoahaz's reign and all his deeds, including the extent of his power, are recorded in the book of the history of the kings of Israel. When Jehoahaz died, he was buried in Samaria with his ancestors. Then his son, Jehoash, became the next king. Jehoash, son of Jehoahaz, began to rule over Israel in the 37th year of King Joash's reign in Judah. He reigned in Samaria 16 years, but he did what was evil in the Lord's sight. He refused to turn from the sins of idolatry that Jeroboam, son of Nebat, had led Israel to commit. The rest of the events in Jehoash's reign and all his deeds, including the extent of his power and his war with King Amaziah of Judah, are recorded in the book of the history of the kings of Israel. When Jehoash died, he was buried with his ancestors in Samaria. Then his son Jeroboam II became the next king. When Elisha was in his last illness, King Jehoash of Israel visited him and wept over him.
My father, the chariots and charioteers of Israel, he cried.
Elisha told him,
Get a bow and some arrows.
And the king did as he was told. When Elisha told the king of Israel to put his hand on the bow, and Elisha laid his own hands on the king's hands, then he commanded,
Open that eastern window.
And he opened it. Then he said,
Shoot!
So he did. Then Elisha proclaimed,
This is the Lord's arrow, full of victory over Aram, for you will completely conquer the Arameans at Aphek. Now pick up the other arrows, and strike them against the ground.
So the king picked them up and struck the ground 3 times. But the man of God was angry with him.
You should have struck the ground 5 or 6 times,
he exclaimed.
Then you would have beaten Aram until they were entirely destroyed. Now you will be victorious only 3 times.
Then Elisha died and was buried. Groups of Moabite raiders used to invade the land each spring. Once when some Israelites were burying a man, they spied a band of these raiders. So they hastily threw the body they were burying into the tomb of Elisha. But as soon as the body touched Elisha's bones, the dead man revived and jumped to his feet. King Hazael of Aram had oppressed Israel during the entire reign of King Jehoahaz. But the Lord was gracious to the people of Israel, and they were not totally destroyed. He pitied them because of his covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And to this day, he still has not completely destroyed them or banished them from his presence. King Hazael of Aram died, and his son Ben-Hadad became the next king. Then Jehoash, son of Jehoahaz, recaptured from Ben-Hadad, son of Hazael, the towns that Hazael had taken from Jehoash's father, Jehoahaz. Jehoash defeated Ben-Hadad on 3 occasions, and so recovered the Israelite towns.